second one. Yeah, that's good. Bora pro.
Bora pro. A little bit of Swedish, too, great. So could you please introduce your colleagues on stage?
Yes, there's a wonderful Swedish background singers. Well, you're Icelandic, but Swedish. My name is Sandra Thorvaldottir. Alexandra Lundqvist.
My father.
Christian
Kronen. But he's from Austria.
Yes. So Christian is from Austria, but those two beautiful ladies are from Sweden. This beautiful lady is my father. yes, we wrote the song together, and he's my manager, producer, and father as well.
Wonderful, wonderful. So, Conchita Wurst was a win. She was one of the most successful winners ever in the modern years of Eurovision. So how do you handle the pressure coming from the same country as Conchita?
Well, I think it's amazing that Conchita had such a success and still has the success. I'm very looking up to her, because Conchita is a person that always fought for her dreams. Like, she participated in many casting shows, also the national pre-selection once, and she always ended up second, always. And she never gave up, which inspires me a lot, because I think that's one of the things you have to do, because all of the people that are very, that have a successful life, a successful job, they're fighters, they really fight for their dreams, and Conchita as well, and you see, it really pays off, and she has a wonderful career, and she's still a very down-to-earth person. So she inspires me a lot.
So where do you get your fighting spirit from? What's your inspiration to just keep on?
Just my dreams. It's just the fact that I've always knew what I wanted to be, what I wanted to do. And sometimes, of course, when I was younger, I was not so sure because of school and people studying and everything. I was like, can I really do this? But being on stage and doing music, writing music, singing, this inspires me so much. It gives, like, people in the audience, they give you so much energy and love. And this always, you know, it's not always easy. You have to work a lot. But those moments when you're on stage and people start singing your song or clap or just smile at you, give you all the energy, this is what inspires you and tells you, okay, wow, everything is worth it.
That's wonderful. Working so closely with your father, what is that like?
Funny. it's nice. I mean, when we write our songs together, it's always a great thing, because we have the same passion about music, we have the same love for music, and also similar ideas, so we don't fight a lot.
That's
like a little bit sometimes, but I think that's normal.
That's quite normal.
But it's funny, it's nice, and we always have a good time. Of course, it's at the beginning it was not that easy, because you have to separate, like, the private life, like my father and daughter, but also handle the manager, music or co-worker thing. But I think we were fine with that.
So who's the boss?
The boss.
Depends on the question, I guess.
It depends, yes. I mean, he tries to be the boss, but it doesn't always work out.
So tell us about your song, the one to see Baron Francis.
Französisch, well, I grew up in Austria. I'm Austrian, I'm not French, but I had the big chance to go to a French school, the Lycée Francilien, which teaches you French from the beginning. When I went to school, I was 5 years old, and I learned everything in French. So, yes, that was the first thing, how I got to learn the language. My father was at the same school, of course, years before me, in the same year. I graduated there, and my grandparents, they live in Paris, like, for 20 years now. At the beginning it was out of business, and now it's a pleasure, I guess. And just, they just love the city, and I visit them almost every year. So I never feel like a stranger when I'm there. And when we started writing music together, I'm sorry I talk so long, but it's like a very long story. And when we started writing music together for the first time, he played something on the guitar, I sang something. We didn't plan anything back then. It was 3 years ago, I think. And suddenly something French came out of my mouth. I don't know, because maybe I came back from school. But it sounded kind of right, and it felt right. So we said, okay, let's write a song just for fun in French, not in English. And, then everything happened. And then we made an album, and then we're here at the Eurovision with a French song.
Oh, great. See, you bought a guitar.
Yes.
I think there's a reason for that, right?
Right.
Please, go ahead. Give us a little taste.
Okay. Yes.
Yes. This one more microphone there? If you need that for the guitar or for the
background. Great. Because of the speed. So you can maybe share.
I'm going to move over because you don't want me in the picture.
We're going to do an acoustic version of one, you see? Shorter version.
To rehearsal. My question is about the choreography, so the movements. How was the preparation of this?
So first we had planned a treadmill, for those who don't know what it is, which included me a few months ago. A treadmill is like the thing where you walk on one place, where you walk like for sports, but I don't like sports, so I wasn't familiar with it. And we tried that at the pre-selection, the national selection. It was planned, but finally, I felt much more secure without it because I can concentrate on the singing, on the emotions. I can let myself, you know, go with the flow of the song and just relax and feel it. Because the treadmill was looking fine, but still I was always a bit worried of like a bit concentrating on it. So I think it's very important that you have to feel comfortable on such a big stage with so many viewers. And so we decided to do it that way, and I'm very happy that it worked out. And for the movements now, we have like the few things you saw. It was planned from the beginning. It also happened in the music video, and we tried to adapt it for a big scene. And yes, I hope it's going to be fun at the semi-final day.
Terrific. Over here, please. Which one? Both. We'll take turns. Here we go.
Hi, I'm Martijn van der Veen from the Netherlands. And I was wondering, you were very young, 4 years old when you made your first record. What kind of record was that?
Well, it was actually my father had a band. I had a band, yes, it was called Paper Moon. It was quite famous in Austria, I can say that. And there was an album, I think the Christmas version as well, called Doop Doop. And actually what I was singing on it was just Doop 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 Doop. I'm sorry, like not a lot, but he also wrote a musical when I was like 4 or 5 years old, I think, and he had a studio back then at home, and there was a little girl in the musical. Her name was Zoe, by coincidence, like me, and I sang for her. It was my first experience in the studio, and yes, I grew very fond of it, but it was not like now.
Okay, great. So, question. Let's take the one to the side, Alistair, first, and then we have the gentleman over here, and then I have you.
Hi, Zoe. Alistair Birch from SBS Radio in Australia. Before I ask my question, big thank you to Vienna and the RAF for looking after us so well last year. It was fun. But that leads on to my question. You were involved in Eurovision at the Rat House. Can you tell us a little about that? And how has that prepared and inspired you for this year?
No, actually last year I was at the national selection for Austria. I participated already. I just finished school and I re-sang that song to the OF. And then suddenly I got from round to round to round, and I wasn't expecting to get that far in the first place at all. And suddenly I was there on stage with the make-makes, with Ava, with everybody else. And I didn't win last year, but I think what happened was just that I, for the first time, I realized that I could really do this, because I never would have expected it. I never allowed myself to dream of that before. And then I just felt it was so close. It was like, okay, maybe I can have the chance to do this. So that gave me a lot of courage also to try it this year. And I'm very happy that I didn't give up already.
So are we. Here we go.
Hello, Zoe. Hello, Team Austria. JP from Radio International. I have a question regarding the song or the animation for singing like Vanessa Paradis from the 80s. Was she an animation for you?
Actually, I heard Vanessa Paradis like a few times now as a comment that I remind people of her. I have not thought about that. I mean, she had Johnny Depp, so that's amazing. So yeah, thank you. But it was not planned that, like I said before, the French just happened by coincidence, and everything, the song was, we wrote together, it was just, it was less than of our album in the original version, and we changed it a little bit to make it more Eurovision and to make it more for the big stage, but of course not to lose the spirit of the song. And I don't know it. I don't know. Maybe it's the French. I don't know. But thank you very much.
I have a second question. It's to do with your acting career. What type of acting do you do?
Actually, when I was younger, I was in an improvising course, if you call it that. When I went to school, everything was very strict. I was sitting all day, and then once a week, I had the chance to just let my crazy Zoe out and improvising. I loved it. And then I really grew fond of the idea of acting. I really wanted to do it. That was a really strong passion inside of me. And I really wanted to do both. Like when I was younger, I wanted to be musical because it kind of fits the two together. But I don't like dancing, so I'm a very bad dancer. But in Austria, there's a very famous Austrian television, the most famous Austrian television series. Like if you call it that way, Vorstandweiler. Mm-hmm. It's like an Austrian special, not Desperate Housewives style, but a little bit like about women who live their lives with lies and sex and everything. And I was not part of those women, but I was the I was the girlfriend of one of their sons. And it was my first acting job ever, and I really loved it because it was just a little small part. But then this summer and October as well, I was on set for Prega, which is a krimi, like a thriller, an Austrian thriller, and it was amazing because I had like 12 days of filming, and I didn't feel like a stranger, but really part of the whole film family. And I really want to do this in my future life. This is one of my biggest dreams, in like holding hands with singing, singing and acting, both my dreams.
Thank you. We have time for one more final question. It's you. Here we go.
Hello Zoe, I'm Farouk from Eurovision magazine in France. Congratulations for your performance today. And my question is, your song has something special. Few people talks in French or is speaking French, but after hearing your songs, they are singing. What did he say? They have talked French since forever. How do you explain that?
I don't know. I think it's some. I experienced that when I was in Amsterdam, in London, in Tel Aviv. When I first went on stage, I was so confused because I thought there was something wrong with the playback because I heard so many voices singing the song. And I thought, this cannot be possible that the people are really singing along. And then I looked and I saw it was, I mean, this video on YouTube, I cried a little because it because it really was the most touching thing ever to see people sing your song in another language, in another country. And I don't know, maybe it's just, it's of course it's not like hard, like long sentences so you can remember it easily, but I think it's also like the positive energy of the song, I hope, which just inspires people to want to sing along and clap along. And yes, the energy of the people is amazing, like in the whole Eurovision family, I call it that. It was just, for the first time I've ever experienced something simple, it was amazing. I was completely overwhelmed by the love and energy. Maybe that's why they felt it again.
Terrific. One final question for me.
Yes.
Come Together, yes. The theme of this year. What does that mean to Soyuz? To Soyuz.
For me, is it like we're from all around the world almost, like in Australia. It's like amazing to have the chance to meet so many people from so many different countries who are competing in a peaceful competition with music, which is so beautiful because music, like we all want to love and share and everything. It's amazing. I'm so happy that I can be part of that Come Together theme and the whole Eurovision thing. And I think I've never met so many people from so many different countries in my life, and this is so special. I really am glad of having the chance to be part of this. Yeah.
Well, thank you very much for being here.
Thank you very much.